Generous Kazinda, a curriculum development specialist, noted that there are various initiatives the National Curriculum Development Center has done to improve on the special needs and inclusive education. Among these include introduction of sign language at lower curriculum.
Using pictures, real life situation, because for them they depend on seeing observation, so they use also real pictures and the stories, as I showed you, that they want to read the stories, and stories have to be with many pictures.
She, however, noted with concern that curriculum developers have noticed that some subjects like science don't align with some children with special needs, like the visually impaired, since it is practical.
The nature of their disability may not allow them to do practicals. If they can do practicals, well and good. Let them do. Even A level, we have no problem. But we are looking at those who are completely unable to do practicals.
Dr. Pamela Nizeimana emphasized the need for capacity building in learning. She appealed to teachers to be innovative despite the big enrollment in schools.
So one teacher per class, if we use inclusive teaching methods, catering for individual differences, use differentiation, use collaborative teaching, use peer-to-peer support methods, it will help to support everyone.
Dr. Patrick Ojok, a lecturer and head of the Department of Community and Disability at Chambogo University, has appealed to NCDC to find an alternative science package for the visually impaired students.
Students with a visual impairment encounter in learning the other science subjects, the traditional ones like biology, chemistry, physics.
Through various programs, the government has made progress in ensuring the delivery of inclusive and quality education for all. The most outstanding programs are universal secondary education and universal primary education, which have led to an increase in enrollment by 4.7%.
If the general science prepares the students with the blindness and other visual impairment to be able to progress beyond secondary.
Out of the 1,370,583 students enrolled in secondary school in Uganda, 8,945 students, that is 0.6%, have special learning needs. Visually impaired students comprise the largest share of these students, followed by those with physical disabilities. Story by Sharon Nabasirie for the news.